Well, hello everyone, and welcome yourselves back on in to Manalords, the mega colony on the big patch. I hope you're all well, and thank you so much for joining me. So, in the last episode, we got up to 42 population. Don't worry about the food here. This is about to go back up in the new year anyway. And we are good on tier 2 already with the church in, and here's where we're at with the marketplace. So everything is pretty damn good. So we're going to need to just get in a second variety of clothing real soon when we've got the spare families. But that's really easy because this one is going to become the cobbler workshop. And I'm going to turn off the thingy there. And we're also then going to turn back on the... No, I'm not going to turn the tanner on until we've got a new family. And I'm going to set these to be upgraded so they get built first. They're on high as well. And we started a few little farmhouses down here. But I want those ones to be upgraded first so they get them moved in. And these are going to be little veggie gardens leading onto our farms here. So we have officially got the farmhouse, and we will be starting this in a moment. I just need to make sure I've got another house for another family to come in. Hopefully these upgrades get done. There we go. Cobbler shop has been completed, so we're just going to make sure they're all good, which they are. And if we go in here now, we have 12 archers. So we are soon going to be binning off the spearmen. I think I'll keep them for now just as an extra, because we are going to need something for that. I think we're miles away anyway, so it should be fine. There we go. We have the family now, so let's turn on the farmhouse. So they should. I'm going to pop one of these. Says we're running out of food. Do not worry about that. This is going to be wheat. They're on 100%. It's crazy. So we need to turn all these on. So we're going to do our usual farm where we have three of them on rotation. So I'm going to pin them so you can see. And there we have it. So each year you've got 1, 2, 3 covered for each year. So that's exactly how we'd like to do it to start for the first, well, second year. And that'll get the goods in that we need. Let's go ahead and pause the marketplace for a minute. And let's get a second family in there. I do want that plowed nice and early. I'm going to continue this on. So we're going to continue with 2 more chickens in these houses. I know you might think that's weird, but I'm going to turn off the marketplaces as well. We're going to try and get early eggs now. That should be fine, and it should be enough for what we need, especially as we'll have a variety, so a surplus will kind of kick in. At the moment, we don't have any food coming in. It's going to take them a long old while to get this done, this field, but I'm hoping we're going to have some done because they are quite big. So I've got 2 families working that without plowing, but it should be fine, I reckon. And I see why our food went down, by the way. It's because the family is actually working on this garden right here. They're about to finish, so we should be okay. That's fine. They were working on their garden, so it timed pretty badly, but that's fine. So they'll be picking up the berries again now. Unfortunately, the wild animals is just not going back up, so we got to wait for that one as well. What we'll do is get a second family in the forager's hut that's spare now as well, and that should bring it back up. It's crazy how much it can dip just because they were working on this, but that's fine. They won't need to touch it now until it's grown. And there we go. Eggs coming in now as well, so they're going to be our buffer, and then the berries should be picking up as well. As it stands, all we've got at the moment is that. So meat. It bugs me, the meat, how long it takes them to get back up. But it's fine. We're not going to rely on that once this is done. That's definitely going to be okay, I think. Hopefully we can start sowing that. I'm going to get a third family now in that one to try and get this done that little bit quicker. And I might leave those in there now. So for the sake of trying to get more in, I'm going to get 1 or 2 more. I think we'll go with those. I'm going to leave that. So 1 more egg place in. That should be fine. Berries are coming in now anyway. And the extra families, we can open up a slot if we want over here as well. They're plowing that nice and quick. It is May still. I think we'll still get a good amount of growth from that one, so I'm not too concerned. As you can see now, we got a nice chunk of warbows in. So as the families come in, we're going to fill up these archer units, which is great. I'm not buying in spears or anything at the moment, so I might just have 1 spear unit. We could set up a trade route for that. Obviously, at the moment, I can turn this back on and we can start that. So let's say... just 2 spears to be imported, and we'll have to do the same for these as well. And then we're going to set up a shoe trade, so we're going to export, and we're going to have a desired amount of 20 shoes as well. So once they're done, we'll get all that going. There we go. Food buffered now, nice amount of berries. They're going to obviously, we're good for a few months on those, so we'll keep that ticking up nicely. And then I think we'll get our first vegetables and a bunch more eggs in when we can as well. And hopefully our meat reserves will go up now, which it's starting to. Lovely. And the storehouse is now pretty full, so we're going to have to hit an upgrade on that one. Is that planks? It is. The saw pit really, really has changed, and it is so fast. So I'm going to have to keep a close eye and micromanage that one, because the planks are just crazy right now. We're also going to turn the tanner back on now. So we've got some hides, but no leather. no problem at all. And we are still planting, but they are rather slow. As you can see, they've carved out a big area right now. There we go. This is growing. It is June, so we should be all right. It's on 5%. It might not show. We might not get any harvest. We'll see. But it's on rotation now, so each will be good to go. Got enough families to keep it open too. I'm going to go ahead and get a second horse for the trade post now. We're starting to make some money from this, which is good. And I think they're coming in now. 20 archers, and we should be getting the spears and stuff in a moment as well. There we go. A good number. It's all berries at the moment, but that's fine. And as the eggs and stuff come in, I'm hoping they distribute into the houses, which it looks like they are. As what little bit of meat and eggs we get, they are going into them. So we'll keep them happy-ish based on that. Clothing, they all have shoes and leather where needed, and the fuel is looking good as well. So what we're going to do is actually go in and set up a meat import now. They're relatively cheap, so we're going to try and keep 10 in, and I'm going to open the trade route for that as well. So we're going to start importing meat when we hit a certain number here. Everything else we're going to leave, so veg and stuff will tick up, and then when the families are in here, which they are, we can also set these to veggie gardens now. All three, so not large, but just enough to keep them good. And we're not going to allow market stalls from these guys. I'm going to be very strict with how we do the setups. And there we go, we're looking good now. So I'm going to assign one more person now to the granary, and that one should make a market stall when possible. So that should be all we need to consider. And there it is. Right, three food stores, so they should be able to distribute these berries and food across nicely as they come in. And as the meat comes into the marketplace, they'll go and grab that as well. All right, so for the sake of us getting our church to tier 2 and keeping happiness high, I'm going to go ahead and get clay. And I'll probably put in an iron pit as well. So we can just mine it out and get rid, so that's fine. And then we can turn that into, hopefully, more farmland. All right, so we're very much into the territory of getting two families in at a time. And because of that, then, we're going to want to make sure we're ramping up houses here. I kind of want to keep that slot free, but I think the tavern might be able to fit in there. So I'm going to go with here. And I think we're going to have one singular double in there. And then I'm going to continue on along here for something similar. Just enough to get a small business at the bottom of that one as well. And I think we're making a good amount from the bows now as well. So we're in a really good place for that. There we go, we are going to get some wheat. Perfect. So not loads, but we're going to get just a little bit before it ends. So we can officially start milling that up soon. I'm going to just collect it for now. Right, how are we doing here? Nice, good amount of storage. And a new bandit camp is here. So we might need to, I think that the ruler's army is going to go deal with that. They're down in the bottom right corner. So we probably want to go and get that for ourselves for our treasury. So I'm going to do that. And we're going to send them straight in, I think. And we're just going to kind of come over to this area over here and try and take that. I think we'll get there first so I can take the goods. And I've just noticed, so we've got this bit coming up here. If I attach a road into this, that's much quicker for our storehouse, large storehouse, to be able to get to these three houses here as well. I know it teleports, but I like to role play it. And we're going to really test out the archers now. We've got one guy that was just ready there. We're going to have those guys there. I believe they have much more range now. So here they come. Won't mind a quick sprint to get you in line. And then we'll slow you down. So we're going to line them there. I do believe they have much better range, as you can see here, that light circle. And let's get to a test in here. And as the arrows rain in, see if we actually kill any. As they get close, it will be right. Oh, wow. Maybe not. It doesn't matter because they're clashing against our spearmen now. So they didn't do anything. I know it's not a full thingy, so that's fine. But right, we're going to get these pushing in. Hopefully, we're going to kill them nice and quick. So I'm going to send the archer squad back now. Actually, no, I'm going to send those onto that camp. And you can sprint onto that. Go, go, go. And then these guys go back before the other ones steal it. And there we go. And we're going to go straight to our treasury. We're going to start building up a nice amount in there so we can get full retinue early on as well. All right, I'm going to double assign to the forester's hut now so they can kind of keep up. It takes a while to grow, so we want a bunch of trees down. I've upped the woodcutter's lodge as well to get a nice surplus of that. Food, I'm okay with. We're going to reduce the forager's hut now. Wild animals are fine. We've got all of these guys that are going to be doing stuff in here. So hopefully we're going to get some kind of yield from one of them. We might get some carrots here. And look at that. It was actually a decent thingy. It says 6, but if you hover over, it's actually 34 here. So they should go ahead and cut that one down. And then trade-wise, we're going to put a third person in the trading post. That's going to be where we kind of keep our money and food nice and high. And here comes the harvest. So it's way more than it said. Look, we've got a nice little amount to start with. But because it hit October, we're going to lose all of this. That'll all disappear. So they'll need to obviously go on to the next one here. Because October hit, it's really strange. They weren't able to get it in time. So we were about a month shy, which is okay. This one will be perfect, but we did get some. That's the main thing, right? So what we're going to want is a granary over this way. We're going to need stone before we can do that, actually, aren't we? Which we did grab. So I'm going to get Stonecutter's Camp going. I'm going to start collecting that. What we'll do is get enough for the granary here. So we're going to get one over this way. And this is going to be maining for all of the farmland here. All right, in order to get these spears, then, we're going to need to open a trade route. And same with the large shields. It's going to cost us a fortune. But we should be able to get them in at least. I think I could afford both right now. So I'm going to establish the route for both. What we can do is go into creating these ourselves. So from the planks, we're going to want that anyway. Now planks are being low again. We're going to need to turn that bad boy back on. And we're going to need to turn one of these houses. So let's get another upgrade here. And that one is going to be our woodworker's kind of shop to get some shields in. And we're going to pause the forager's hut again now. And hunting limit's still on this. So it's kind of stuck around this number now. We don't have a lot of this to kind of get us through, but we do have trading. We should see veg and eggs. Anyway, for the sake of the meat yield or getting some food in, I'm going to have to go ahead and hit some upgrades over here. And that's going to be one of them. So I'm going to get that one upgraded. That one upgraded. And that one upgraded. All right, with this tier 2 in, then let's go ahead and get the joiner's workshop now. That should affect only that one bit of family for now. And coming to kind of think of it, we may need to get ourselves some goat sheds in as well. So some of the houses are going to need to be that. We've got a settlement level increase. And a lot of it, to be fair, we are having issues. So import, I think we go this way because we're not very lucky on what we can do with food. We could grab this for double meat harvest, but it's not giving us much. We're going to be on bread soon anyway, but let's go ahead and get better deals. So our import tariff means we should be able to then unlock more food trade. So at the moment, we're importing meat. It's a little bit cheaper. Could probably do the same for eggs. We'll just say 10 and we'll get a trade route for that as well. And then as that starts to get surplus and once we start getting these veggies in, we should be fine. So you're still better off. My test kind of proved it. Veggie garden, very first thing you put in is better than eggs. So eggs just doesn't produce enough. It's producing enough. Like I'm seeing them go into the houses, but we're never getting a surplus, right? And I think it's time to grab our windmill ready as well. So we need somewhere where it's got good efficiency. I might pop it. Oh man, those trees. I think that'll be fine. 95 is good enough for me. And look at all that stone, 193. Holy crap. Right, let's get some of that exporting now. We only want 30. Get rid of the rest. Let's open a trade route for that as well. It's nice and cheap. I'll probably keep this guy working in there because we've got spare hands anyway. And then what I'm going to do is get the rest built and ready for baking bread. So we lost that harvest, unfortunately, but we're going to pop a granary over here as well. So we'll go with communal oven there. So it can go farmhouse, mill, communal oven. So really farmhouse should have been here. Mill here, communal oven, granary. And then the communal oven goes to the granary. They take it to the market. So I'm hoping to have a market stall maybe over here. And then we can get housing coming this way. Yep, that's perfect. So let's get the granary over this side then. So I'm thinking about here. So they'll be able to collect from these farmhouses too, I'm hoping. That's obviously going to have only certain things. We're going to allow market stall setups. So that's fine. That's only going to then have mainly the bread stuff, though. I'm going to need a new market eventually. So I'm going to get that preemptively down. And I think I'm going to try and get a 2-row one here. That's okay, I think. Not too big. And then the next lot of houses I'm going to bring this way. I'm going to do the same again. I think I'm going to have some farms along here. There we go. We'll get a few more in. Another bandit camp. I'm not going to bother with that one. Raiders are going to attack us, though, real soon, actually. We've got enough. I think we're good against the raiders. So we'll tank with the spears and we'll have the archers ready. We've got bloody hell, we've been making small shields. That's fine. We need some anyway. So actually we could hit up one of these. I want to try the militia footmen. All right, this granary is here then. So let's go ahead and do what we want to do. So I'm going to say, actually, you guys are allowed all this, but your main focus is going to be, let's say no to beer. Your main focus is going to be that stuff. Yeah, that's fine. And then we can get one assigned to that one. I'm hoping the family inside of this one should go and grab from the trading post when they're able to. All right, we managed to get one more unit in before they attack then. So they're going to be coming from quite far away. So they're coming from over here. And it's just two raiders, so more than, yeah, we're more than fine. So I'm going to go ahead though and get my guys ready. Oh, we managed to get two more in because we managed to make a couple of shields beforehand. It's good. We're going to take them off sprint. And let's fight them over here. We go for a full thin line of that, and then we'll have the archers in the back here. Oh, they're claiming Waldbrand as well. Please do. That's fine. I'll take you out later. Well, we'll be fighting anyway. The archers have a really good range now. Look at that. That's where we need to fight, actually. Get in on that. That's the play right there. The family is hungry. Oh, God. Hello. What's the issue, guys? Sorted out. They've plowed this, though. Now it's March, which is fantastic. So that's going to start growing. 168. So we're going to have bread this year anyway. Let's take a look. Okay, let's get this turn back on. Don't need any building happening until the next family. Berry deposit's growing, so let's do that. We'll sort out the rest of the burgage plots in a moment. Where are these raiders? I think they've gone. I don't know whether the ruler killed them all, to be fair, guys. So that's actually great, but I'm going to keep them here for a minute just in case. But I think we're looking good. Yeah, obviously ignore that. I've never had actually this many issues with food, so they must have changed. The berries are back now, so that's going to be coming in, and veg is coming in, and the eggs are coming in, so we should be fine. Not concerned. There's no deaths happening, and we are good. All right, no raiders apparent then. Let's go ahead and send these guys home. So we can carry on. I'm going to have to pause the stonecutters camp now because we just don't have enough space for them, bless them. But that does mean we can go ahead and get the mining for clay now. And we can start to look at getting the church upgraded as well. We're fine on the approval anyway, so we probably want to get one more upgraded to tier 2. And let's go with this one here because that's going to be another point. And I think I'm going to get my first goat shed in here. And I might get one over here. So we'll have two goat sheds. That's just going to buffer our hides a little bit. We've got a little bit of grain, actually. So I think I can go ahead and mill that into flour. So we didn't lose it. Perfect. And then communal oven. Let's bake a bit of bread as well. You're not allowed a marketplace. We want it to go to the granary. They'll do the marketing. Thank you very much. Once again, veggie plots over here, so they're all going to be veggies along here as well. If you didn't know, guys, I'm hoping for some seriously sizable. I kind of want to fill the whole square, you know. We'll do smaller ones as well, but my main focus is going to be filling this whole square. And there we go. That is another year pretty much in the books now as well, so looking pretty solid. I'm going to get a tiny bit more upgraded here. So these are going to be our first batch of tier 2s, and then we can work on getting some beer. So I might pop these on rotation. I reckon we can get that. Flax is also another option because we've got such good farming. So actually, that should have been barley there. We're going to need another farmhouse. And we'll have barley there. That means we're going to... Yeah, one more farmhouse will do. And that will cover these. Let's go in there as well. And the Lord is claiming everywhere. I'm not even going to contest him at the moment. And there we go. We managed to import all the stuff now. Is the bread coming in? Am I seeing that right? Yes, I am. Beautiful. Are you getting that bread in? Yes, he is. Very nice. Some very happy customers here now. Lovely stuff. So we want to work on maybe another type of clothing here. We've got three goat sheds in now. So hide should be coming in. Got our first bit of clay as well. So we're going to also go ahead and get our smelter in. So we're going to go for our clay furnace. And we are going to pop the clay furnace. Let's just go here for now. I have no problems with that industry-wise. And we're going to go for a third family in... Let's go for four in the large storehouse now. And then we're going to assign one more over to this one here. We're going to have two and two. And then we'll go three and three eventually as well. And there you go. Before you know it, then the vegetables are in. Food is just flying up now. Happy days. So we're going to ramp it up now. We've got no space in our houses. I'm going to see if there's any that can be upgraded. There isn't, so I'm gonna, my last one here after fixing this is gonna be a case for getting a bunch more housing in. And where better than over here to do this? So these roads here might get changed. I'm gonna use this bit because we've got that second marketplace now. So we'll get two more in there. And maybe I don't want to go into the thingy there, into the hunter's camp at all. So we want to be careful what we're doing. And I'm going to match up to this, hopefully, with one more. Lovely. And let's get two more in this. That's a big one. Gonna have to do this in a different way like that. So we'll do them individually. Then we got room for anything else inside of here if we need. So if we want another well, we can slap one in there. And there we have it, guys. Look at it. We're getting somewhere, aren't we? It looks fantastic, man. It's gorgeous. We're completely set up. And I'm going to build around the church this way as well. We're going to have more than one church, by the way, if we're going to build big as well. And I may also get in some farmland up this side as well. We'll see. But as always, guys, really, really appreciate you. Smash the thumbs up. Subscribe if you aren't already. And as always, really appreciate you. If you want to support me further, do consider Patreon or a membership on the channel. Have a great day, guys. Take it easy, and I'll see you soon.